हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल लर्निंग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी स्टेप अप चॉपर विद रेजिस्टिव लोड। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड द स्टेप डाउन चॉपर विद रेजिस्टिव लोड एंड आरएलई लोड, एंड वी हैड आल्सो डिराइव्ड सम एक्सप्रेशंस रिलेटेड टू स्टेप डाउन चॉपर। सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी दोज वीडियोज, यू कैन चेक इट इन द चैनल प्लेलिस्ट। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड ऑल्सो प्रेस द बेल आइकन सो डेट यू कैन गेट मोर अपडेटेड वीडियोज फ्रॉम हियर। So in this lecture we are going to study step up chopper with resistive load in the continuous current conduction mode. So these are the topics which we are going to discuss in this lecture. First one is operation of step up chopper with resistive load. Then second one is derivation of output or load voltage equation. Now let us discuss some important points related to step up chopper. This step up chopper is also called as boost converter. This is the circuit diagram of the step up chopper. So the step up chopper is a static device that steps up or raises its DC input voltage, which is given by Vs. So as this step up chopper raises or steps up the DC input voltage is called as step up chopper or boost converter. In this type of chopper, the average output voltage is greater than the fixed DC input source voltage. That means if we are taking the average output voltage across the load as Vo, then in this boost converter, what happens? The average output voltage will be greater than the input DC voltage Vs. As you can see in the diagram, it consists of DC input voltage, a boost inductor L, a controlled switch, which is a SCR we are using here, a diode D, a filter capacitor C, and load resistance R. Here the capacitor is connected, which is called as filter capacitor. The presence of this capacitor is optional. This capacitor limits the output voltage ripple and it must provide the output DC current to load when the diode D is off. Here we can see that we are using a SCR. So in place of SCR, this step up chopper can use power devices such as power BJT, power MOSFET, GTO or force commutated thyristor as switch. So in place of SCR, we can use power devices such as power BJT, power MOSFET or GTO, or this is a force commutated SCR which we are using as a switch. So any of these devices can be used as switch here in this boost converter. Next one is operation of step up chopper with resistive load. Here we are considering continuous current conduction. The operation of the step up chopper is divided into two modes of operation. First one is mode 1. It occurs during the interval 0 to dt, and mode 2 operation occurs during the interval t is equal to dt to t is equal to capital T. Here T is called as the chopping period, and here D is the duty cycle or duty ratio. This is the circuit diagram of the step up chopper or boost converter. Here we have replaced the SCR with a switch. We have assumed the input source voltage as Vs, which is a DC source voltage. L is called as the boost inductor. Here one switch SW is connected, D is a diode and C is the filter capacitor. The IL current is the current through the inductor, VL is the voltage across the inductor, IS is the current through the switch SW, IO is the load current as you can see here, VO is the voltage across the load, and IC is the current through the capacitor. First, we will understand mode number 1 operation, which is energy storing mode, and it occurs during the interval t is equal to 0 to t is equal to d into t. So at the time t is equal to 0, what happens? This switch SW goes into the on condition and it starts conducting the current. When it starts conducting the current, it will act as short circuit. As you can see, the voltage across the inductor has the polarity plus on the X point and minus on the Y point because of this DC input voltage. So this minus polarity will go to the P side of the D diode, therefore it will go into the reverse bias condition and eventually it will go into the off condition, or it will act as open circuit. So in the first mode of operation, SW switch will be on, whereas D diode will be in the off condition. When this diode D is acting as a open circuit, then the load is disconnected from the source in the first mode of operation. So now our circuit will look like this after disconnecting the load from the source. So here we can see that one current start flowing into this loop. So this current is called as the inductor current and it is represented by IL. So since the inductor is an energy storing device, as soon as the closed loop is formed, this inductor starts storing the energy during the on period of the switch SW. Okay, and the current through the inductor IL increases linearly from minimum value of I1 to maximum value of I2. Now, when we apply KVL in this loop, what we will get? The source voltage will appear across this inductor. That means in this circuit, the inductor voltage VL will be equal to the source voltage. Now, since the load is disconnected from the source, what about the output load voltage? Output load voltage will be equal to 0 in the first mode of operation. Next mode of operation is mode 2 operation. It is an energy releasing mode and it occurs during the interval T is equal to dt to T is equal to capital T, which is called as chopping period. So at time T is equal to dt, this SW switch goes into the off condition. So therefore it will act as open circuit, as you can see in this diagram. Now what happens due to this open circuit of this switch SW, the current through this inductor get interrupted, and due to the interruption in the current, a EMF is induced across this inductor to oppose the change across this inductor. So the polarity of the self-induced EMF across this inductor will be opposite to that of the voltage across the inductor, which was before in the mode number 1 operation. That means this is self-induced EMF, VL will be negative on the X point and positive on the Y point. So because of this positive polarity on the Y point, this positive will go to the P side of the D diode. So this D diode will go into the forward bias condition and eventually it starts conducting. So in the mode 2 operation, what happens? This SW switch will act as open circuit and current starts flowing in this loop in the clockwise direction. So since the inductor has already stored the energy in the mode number 1 operation, now the energy will be released by the inductor and the current through the inductor starts decreasing from maximum value of I2 to minimum value of IN. So here we can see that since the inductor and this resistor, load resistor, are in series with each other, therefore load current IO and inductor current IL will be equals. So in this mode 2 operation, the inductor current IL or load current, we can say, decreases from maximum value of I2 to minimum value of IN, and the voltage across the inductor during the off condition of the switch can be found out by the KVL. We will get Vs, this will be plus VL, then minus VO is equal to 0. So from this equation, VL will be equal to VO minus Vs. And from this equation, if we find out VO, VO will be equal to VL plus Vs. Now since this VL is the voltage across the inductor and it is given by LdIdt, next we will derive the equation for the load voltage or output voltage of step up chopper with resistive load. So first we will take the mode number 1. In the mode number 1, the circuit diagram of the step up chopper will look like this. After disconnecting the load from the source, only this circuit will be remaining. So in the mode number 1 operation, what we have studied, the SW switch will be on and it will act as short circuit. So the polarity of the voltage across the inductor will be positive on the X point and negative on the Y point. And here if we consider the switch current as IS, so since the switch and the inductor are in series with each other, so in this circuit the inductor current IL will be equal to the switch current IS. Let this be equation number 1. Now if we apply KVL in this loop, by KVL VL we will get VS minus VL is equal to 0. That means we will get VS is equal to VL. Now since this VL is the voltage across the inductor, this can be represented by L di by dt. So here what is I? I is inductor current IL divided by dt. Now this DIL will be the change of current through the inductor. Therefore, we can write DIL as del I. And since this mode number 1 operation is occurring in the on period of the switch, so we can take dt is equal to t on here. So we'll get Vs is equal to L into del I divided by t on. So from this equation, if we find out del I will be equal to Vs into t on divided by L. So this is our equation number 2. And here del I will be equal to maximum value of the inductor current minus minimum value of inductor current. That means I2 minus I1 we have to take, which is equal to IL max minus IL min. Now we'll take the mode 2 operation. This is the circuit diagram of the mode 2 operation. In this condition, the SW switch will be in the off condition, diode D will be in the on condition. So when we apply KVL in this loop, what we will get? By KVL we will get plus Vs, then plus VL, then minus V0 is equal to 0. Now we have to find out the output voltage. So VO will be equal to Vs plus VL. Here VL will be equal to L di by dt. Here what is the current through the inductor? It is equal to IL. So we can take IL here. So since we are talking about the output voltage, this equation can be written as Vs plus L dio by dt. Because here the output current and inductor current will be equal, because the inductor and the resistance will be connected in series with each other when switch SW is in the off condition. So since here the output current is equal to the inductor current, we have written this equation. Now VO can be written as Vs plus L into del I divided by. Now this whole process of mode 2 operation is occurring during the off period of the switch. So here we will take T off in place of dt. Now we will put the equation of del I here from equation number 2. So VO will be equal to Vs plus L divided by T off into Vs into T on by L. This L and this L get cancel out, and we will get Vs plus Vs into T on divided by T off. From this equation, we will take Vs common. So we will get VO is equal to Vs into 1 plus T on divided by T off. Okay, now we will take the LCM. This will be equal to Vs into T off plus T on divided by T off. Now we know that on period plus off period is equal to total time period T. So this equation can be written as Vs into T divided by T off. Now T off can be written as T divided by T minus T on. Now this output voltage VO can be written as T divided by T minus T on into Vs, since the off period will be equal to total time period minus on period. Now we will divide this T in the denominator. We will get 1 upon 1 minus T on by T into Vs. Now we know that on period plus total time period will be duty ratio or duty cycle. So the output voltage VO will be equal to Vs divided by 1 minus D, since T on by T is equal to duty ratio T. So this is the equation of the output voltage for the step up chopper with resistive load, which is equal to the source voltage divided by 1 minus of duty ratio. So hope you have understood the topic. Thank you very much for watching, and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.